We found it interesting that other starters on the offensive line didn't play. They rested the final preseason game. You played significantly. Can you tell us about what you heard about the decision, just like getting that time out there?
Coach wanted me to play, so, I scrapped it on and went out there with my brothers. So whatever coach needed me to do, I'm here for the team.
You feel you got something of value in the final preseason game?
Oh, for sure, no doubt. I might have been the only one playing out there, but I can't put bad stuff on film, so just go out there and playing like I'm next to Dieter or I'm next to Austin Jackson, so.
You moved along with the first, second, third team, first couple weeks of training camp, but it seems like this past 2 weeks or so, you've really been entrenched at that left guard spot. What has kind of clicked for you in being able to really get settled with the first team and keep that spot?
I'm working hard every day, I don't look at where I'm at week to week, because everybody got something to prove on, so I come to practice every day, bashing on myself, being hard on myself, like somebody's trying to take my position as every play, every rep I take. So me being at the ones right now don't mean nothing.
So what do you want to still work on since you said you're such a hard critic?
Just my technique with my hands in the pass pro and my pad level in the run game.
Coach Lem mentioned that he likes to keep track of finishes.
Yeah.
And I was wondering who should I install as the favorite for total finishes, you or Robert Hunt?
My mama always told me not to talk about yourself, let somebody else tell you. So, hey, that's all I'm gonna say. But I'm gonna go with myself. I think I'm the finisher on the offensive line. I think I'm gonna get a good bit of pancakes, a good bit of finish on the field.
Speaking of pancakes, who eats more pancakes on the team?
Honestly, let me think. I really don't know. I don't know who eat the most pancakes on the team.
Robert
I don't.
Said yesterday he's good on the grill. Have you ever gotten a chance to?
I'm the grill master. You can ask Raekwon. When we first got here, our rookie year, he came over. I think I forgot what holiday it was. I put something on the grill. He was like, oh boy, I didn't know you can do this here. Yeah, so you know.
So your mom's advice, does it pertain to you talking about your skills on the grill then?
See, that's a little different. You can talk about the grill, but other than that, you can leave everything else out.
So why did you make that face when he said Robert said that?
That's my brother, man. He's a good griller, too. How about that? He's a great griller, too. He can grill really good, too. Yeah.
So what's the most important thing to do when you're grilling? What's the secret?
Let your charcoals cook for a long time. Don't let them, don't let them stay black. Let them get gray to the point where you touch them and they like go to dust, because that's when the grill is mostly hot. And then clean your grill really, really good. You don't want to put your meat on the grill after you grill up like 2 months ago. Clean your rails and everything, because your meat could come out black and it ain't even done in the inside. So,
What about the season?
Oh yeah, I get down with the season. I got my whole little cabinet with the season. I got good seasoning. I season it real good.
Your go-to?
I can't tell you that. You might steal it.
How did you accumulate your spice jars? Are you going to the store, picking out stuff yourself, ordering online?
I'm a big dude, so grilled food is best for me. So that's my go-to. I go grilled chicken, grilled fish, grilled everything. So that's why I had to specialize in it.
I want to ask one more football question if you're also taking questions on that. Robert Jones, he made the 53. What have you seen out of him, and what impressed him?
Oh, that's my boy, man. We got him a locker right next to him. He's a very hard worker. And like my boy Greg said, they come to practice happy. We come to practice happy as first-year and second-year players. Want to get better. It's a great opportunity to be around something this special, so, and he really picked up on it because he came from a JUCO, then went to Middle Tennessee. Now he's in a big organization like this, so he capitalizing on it. He's a great player.
Did you see the viral play from the last preseason game where Robert Jones, how would you describe it? What did you do to a man?
We seen it on the field. We seen it when we was on the sideline, and like our coach had to say, get back, because we almost ran on the field and like was happy for our guys. It's a brotherhood in that room. So when those guys got in the game and make plays like that, we'd be excited for them.
How would you describe what he did?
That's a vet block, a 10-year vet block. I say that.
What's the chemistry like for you guys as an O-line going into year two? A lot of you guys were rookies last year.
During the offseason, that was one of our things. Our coach wanted us, even though some people wasn't here or been around now, we always talk to each other, because offensive line, all five of us have to be good. One person can be bad, it can be a negative play, but if all five is good, it can be a positive play. And it's like that everywhere on the field, but offensive line is so important to give a call from the right side all the way to the left side. So, you know, our chemistry came together when we was in the offseason talking to talking to each other and everything. So that brotherhood, you can see us outside of here. We're very, very close. We're always laughing and sending TikToks back and forth, all type of stuff.
What's the team O-line bonding experience look like? What do y'all do?
We'll go to Topgolf, and we'll just kick it for like 2 hours. Definitely going to sweat at Topgolf. I did not know you sweat that much at Topgolf. I did not know that.
You're the best golfer in the group.
Not me. Not me.
Solomon, you know, earlier this week, obviously, you know, there's the Deshaun Watson rumors came out, and yesterday and today, Flo is saying, you know, Tua is our quarterback. When you hear that as a member of this team, you know, the Tua is a quarterback, is our quarterback, you know, how does that make you feel as a teammate? How do you think that the rest of the team takes that?
I love every single quarterback here, and I'm sticking with every quarterback Coach Flo puts out there. I'm going to do my job no matter who he put out there, you know, like he said, Tua, so I love Tua. I'm going to block for Tua.
Talking about Rob Hunt earlier, he told us yesterday that he learned how to drive last year.
I mean, he can drive. He can drive now. I mean, when we first got here last year, like, we was driving to go somewhere on the expressway. He texted me, hey, dude, slow down, man. I like, I'm going 60 miles per hour. I'm even going fast. I'm like, bro, what do you want me to do? He say, well, just send me the Jeep. He say, just send me the location. I'll just meet you there because you're going to. I'm like, bro, we both in the slow lane. I'm not even going fast, you know. So, but I think he used to it now. I think he pretty good. He don't need no ride or a Lyft or Uber no more. He can make his own way now.
We just met your new teammate, Greg Manns. What's your first impressions of him?
Yeah, he's a great dude. He's a great dude. I picked his brain a little bit, asked him how many years he's been in the league, how many teams he had him play for and stuff. So I see he got vet experience and he's been in the league for a long time. So, you know, that's another person I can feed off of. That's because I want to be in the NFL that long. So, you know, he's a very hard worker. He's pretty smart, picking up on the plays easily. So, I think he's going to be pretty good to the, he's going to adapt well to the offensive line.
Thank you.